Hey everyone, so Sheldon here with Pagan's Pathway, and today we're going to talk about a really exciting topic, and that's water dowsing, also known as water witching, and I'll tell a little success story at the end. So let's get started. What is this idea of water dowsing? Well, let's start at the beginning of how I understand it and how I was taught. How I was taught is you take a stick or a branch from a tree, clearly, and you cut the middle of it like this until there's about that much left of the stick. And you take either way, you pull them, and then you push them together, so it's kind of like a Y. Nowadays, it's called a Y rod. That's probably why. And so, in water witching, it's this idea that water is flowing under the ground, and it could be found using this stick, pretty much. There's a lot of theories out there. I say theories, there's a lot of ideas and explanations as to how it works. My father is actually the first person who ever told me about it and told me that his grandfather used it. So I just assume his grandfather and his father before him did it also. So if you were taking this, you would use it to find well water because water is very important, but you can't see it flowing under the ground. So this practice kind of started, you know, accumulating, and who knows where it originated. I mean, someone probably knows. I'm not a scholar on water dowsing or water witching, that I've heard it a lot here in the South. But you can figure that out and put it in the comments below. But it's a really cool practice, and now there are things called L rods, and they're just like, if you look at them like this, it looks like an L, but you hold it like this, and they cross. And they can be used for divination, I've heard. So you can like say yes if this, and so it'll cross, or if it says no, then they'll open up. And that's a cool practice also. But we're gonna stay on the topic of water dowsing or water witching. And you'll notice that I'll intertwine those because I've heard both terms a lot. So I took a class on it through the ORI, which is the Ozark Research Institute, which is in Springdale, Arkansas. And they look at all of these like different esoteric ideas like healing and energy work and dowsing and all things like that. And so they teach these classes so that people can get acquainted with things that aren't really taught in classes anymore. And so that's where I learned it. And it was really cool to see because how they would teach you is they would lay down these pieces of fabric that were just, you know, the color of water, so blue. And what you would do is you would just walk and walk, and then all of a sudden your rods would cross where they were supposed to. And that's why you could see it. Well, then they would cover up these things, or they would put like quarters and other things under. And without you knowing where these objects were, it would find them. It would cross where they were, or it would cross when your foot touched it. It depends on how you practice and how it felt more comfortable to you. So then you could go out in the field, and like literally the field, and go and find water for wells. And it's not just water, it's clean, fresh drinking water that's healthy and that'll bring, you know, good, I don't know, sustenance for you. And so it's a really neat practice. And if you have any like success stories or you've heard of this or anything like that, put them in the comments below because I'm very interested in hearing this. So here's one success story that I have, and it's my personal one. A couple of weeks ago, I got a call from my friend Joy, and she lives on this huge, beautiful farm, and they really needed drinking water that was closer to their animals. And so I was like, yeah, sure, I'll come out and I'll douse, I'll see what I can do. And I went through all the motions for my class, but I just didn't feel comfortable with what I was doing. I felt like there was something more I could do. So I really did the older version where, you know, you walk the space, but you first like section out a map of it and you figure it out. And I used a pendulum to do that. And, you know, I just did that. And then I went out in the field and I walked and I found a place. But when I started out to figure out how deep the water could be, it was like 200 feet. Absolutely ridiculous, right? So I walked a little bit more because I thought of how water works and how water moves underground. And so it's kind of like there's caves and caverns, there's springs and things like that. So I was like, well, you know, if it's this much, maybe it's just because there's a built up sediment or a rock formation that's just kind of there. Maybe that's where the water starts. Maybe that's where the spring is. So I walked a couple more feet and then all of a sudden they crossed again. And I checked how deep it may be. It turned out to be 30 to 50 feet, and I was like 75 max. Well, I got a phone call a few days ago from Joy, and it was amazing because she said it was 40 feet, and it wasn't only 40 feet, but it was, I think it's 80 gallons per minute of water, and that she actually said that we hit an aquifer, and so it was like, they'll never run out of drinking water. Amazing. Like, I was so excited and so, like, blown away because, you know, I've done it before, but it's usually, oh, well, you were close, and it was about, you know, you were like 10 feet off and stuff like that. Or, well, we have some water, but it's only a few drops, so it's not really worth it. And so for this to actually happen, I was blown away. I was so excited. So if you have any stories, success stories, or anything like that, please put them in the comments below. I know I said that like 3 times. And make sure you subscribe to the channel because there's going to be fun and exciting topics, not only this kind, but also the fun ones that I like to go out and show you what I do throughout the day. And I'll make some movies or some short films so you can watch something and it's not just, you know, the boring stuff or... If you consider it boring, I think it's fascinating. The topics on paganism, esoteric things, and these old folk tales and folk remedies and stuff like that. So make sure you subscribe and follow me on Twitter at Pagan's Pathway. I'm Sheldon Slinkard, and I'm here to be Pagan's Pathway. And yeah, love and light, blessed be anything that makes you feel happy. I'm Sheldon Slinkard, and I approve this message.